Coming up next, Eye on America. Tonight, the growing popularity of heroin and the unlikely people now using it. Has the potential for making a deadly comeback. He says inhaling heroin is now the in thing in the big city nightclub scene. But heroin abuse now goes far beyond the city limits, as Bob Fall reports in tonight's Eye on America.
Everybody gets to walk.
Turn around. Need another set of cuffs.
Bring him back here.
Thousands of times I could have been shot in the head or held up.
Oh, yeah, I can see the blood on the end.
I was definitely out of control.
Where are you getting your money from?
I just love heroin. It's great.
Now in rehab at Phoenix House, 23-year-old Karen Grigsby was a nice girl from a wealthy suburb. 4 years ago, when she began experimenting with heroin, she joined a growing population, heroin junkies who don't live in Hollywood or the inner city.
How does a good girl from a Catholic school get to that point?
It's like a physical addiction and a mental. Heroin, it's like you get sick if you don't do it. My mother would just look at me sometimes and she'd be like, what is the matter with you?
With heroin, it's like a warm blanket over you. It's like security.
It's just, it's the ultimate high. That's, you know, it was great.
Now, one-time users are trying to overcome the allure of a drug once associated with dirty needles.
It gave me so much confidence, you know, took away a lot of my insecurities that I have.
A false confidence which once permitted Karen to hold down a good job.
At my job, they had no clue. Everybody thinks that a heroin addict just sits there and like nods and scratches all day. And yeah, you're gonna be scratching and you're gonna be like getting like the throaty voice, but you could still function.
Law enforcement officials say heroin is more popular now because it's cheaper and more pure, up to 85% pure in some cases.
Good boy. Check back here.
At ports and airports around the country, U.S. Customs officers are looking for and finding more heroin. Just yesterday, U.S. drug czar Lee Brown said the government should spend another $350 million to curb the flow of illegal drugs.
America has to be concerned about the drug problem. We have a very, very serious drug problem in this country, and it's not getting any better. That's the bottom line.
And big city cops like Newark, New Jersey Captain Gerard Inio report more heroin arrests.
They're snorting it, they're shooting it, they're smoking it. We're getting less and less of cocaine and more heroin now.
Anybody in there?
Which means you have to do what? More of this sort of thing?
More of this sort of thing.
But you're swimming upstream.
Yes, of course.
Cops in small towns like Sergeant Harold Valentine in Holyoke, Massachusetts, are also reporting more heroin arrests, and not just of the likely suspects.
We've had nurses, we've had band directors, we've had a weather person, we've had firemen. We've had people in law enforcement.
While police say they are cracking down, those for whom heroin is a way of life agree that the fear of arrest or of jail is not a deterrent.
You have to get sick and tired of being sick and tired.
If I was to split from here and go back out there, I'm truly, honest to God, I feel I'm going to die. Because I'm not going to stop. I'm just going to go out full-fledged, and I'm just going to OD. And just, you know, die.
Get him in.
Said one user, every decade there's a new hot drug. In this case, it's an old enemy targeting people you might not suspect. In Long Island City, New York, this is Bob Fall for Eye on America.
Still to come on the CBS Evening News, a winter kind of sport.
Can't believe we're talking about